Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on back. Today we're going to be ranking every single Zombies game. Now there are 10 Zombies games from Call of Duty World at War to Call of Duty Vanguard. We're going to be ranking them between a mixture of the map and also the mechanics as well. So it's going to be a bit of both. Coming into our number 10 spot, y'all already know it's going to be Call of Duty Vanguard. Coming into our 9 spot, ladies and gentlemen, now we got a great spot. This is going to be Exo Zombies. Now, with Exo Zombies, essentially, the problem with Exo Zombies, I find, is that the gun balancing is really not that great. Here's some gameplay of me, Chopper, Noah, and Dalek doing the Descent Easter egg. The gun balancing is terrible in this game. I'm telling you, past round 15, past round 20, I don't care what map you're playing on, your guns are going to be doing literally zero damage. And this is the problem. There's a 20 pack punch tier system in this game that makes it so difficult to actually do anything or get anywhere, and even the wonder weapons on this game are terrible. A lot of the maps are also the same. The Zombies was essentially made after the game and put into the game as a DLC 1 because of the fact that people were upset, including myself, that Exo Survival was in the game but not Exo Zombies. But then it made the worst iteration of Exo Zombies, so I don't know. Of the worst iteration of zombies in general. So I honestly don't really know what the proper solution is there, but that's Exo Zombies. I mean, we all dislike it. There's only 4 maps. The only person that I've ever met in my entire life that's actually liked it is Noah J456. Now, I don't know what that's saying. I don't know if that's just because he solved all the Easter eggs first. You let me decide. You tell me, boys. But coming in into our next spot, I think you guys are actually going to be very shocked by this. But ladies and gentlemen, this is actually going to be World War II Zombies. Now, with World War II Zombies, I actually really enjoyed this mode. I think the problem with this mode on launch was it came after a really good mode. It came after IW. And the thing with World War II is that it's really difficult to play. To be honest, it's very hard to play. The weapons are good. They're much better balanced than Exos, which is why I think it is better than Exos. I really like the Final Reich, but a lot of the other maps on this game aren't that great, in my opinion. I think the Shadow Throne is good, but everything else other than the Shadow Throne and the Final Reich is really awful. It released probably one of my least favorite Zombies maps to date, being the Tortured Path, which isn't even really Zombies at the end of the day. I don't know what the heck they were thinking with that mode. I do like a lot of the customization with this game, though. There are a lot of cool hidden characters that you can unlock rather than it just being about the operator system. The Easter eggs were pretty fun. I think the thing that really bogs this game mode down for me is really just the graphic fidelity. I don't know what it is, the constant jump scares as well with the zombies. It's just not that fun. I don't know why I don't necessarily gravitate to it. I know there's a lot of World War II Zombies fans out there, but I definitely think it's one of the worst non-Treyarch game modes to date. And honestly, I don't really see myself going back to play it other than for round 100 and for Final Reich and Shadow Throne, basically. But that is World War II Zombies. I mean, let me know what you guys are thinking down in the comment section below about what you're thinking. Now, I think a lot of people are actually going to be kind of upset with this next pick because this is actually a main Treyarch title. This is the first main Treyarch title. Coming into our next spot, this is actually going to be BO4 Zombies. Now, with BO4 Zombies, I like it, man. It's just the thing is that it's so hard to come back and play this mode. I remember playing this game early, and I didn't even have a problem with the HUD. To be honest, the HUD was not even the worst part about BO4. It's mainly just the gameplay. Like, a lot of the maps I really dislike. Like, this map suffers from the BO2 effect, where it has some of the best maps, but also some of the worst maps, which is very strange to me. And also, there you can see, you can pull out any specialist weapon in this game, and it's your get-out-of-jail-free card. I mean, this game did have gauntlets, which was a lot of fun. It had a lot of different game modes and a lot of great aesthetics, honestly, with the guns. But the problem, I think, is just within the gameplay. There's nothing really coming, making me come back to play this game. I mean, there's high rounds. That's a lot of fun. I don't like the elixirs for high rounds either. I think them changing it from gobblegums back in BO3 into BO4 into elixirs was not really that great of an idea. It just, I don't know. Again, BO4 has some of my favorite maps in terms of, like, 9, Ancient Evil. I even like Dead of the Night a lot. But also has some of my least favorite, like Voyage, Blood, Alpha Omega. And I kind of like Tog as well. But, I mean, These maps are just not fun, and I think a lot of people are dislikers of Black Ops 4. I like a lot of aspects of BO4, but to me, it's just, in terms of the overall experience, it's just not that great. And also, by the way, I should mention that we are talking about zombies only, and I also have sort of made this list based off of my playtime with each of these modes. And BO4, I definitely have a lot less playtime next to this next spot, and coming in at our next spot, and I cannot believe I'm saying this, because this is crazy. The next spot that we have is Call of Duty World at War. I have definitely put in more time into Call of Duty World at War, even after it came out, when I started, my first game was Black Ops 1, and I went back and played the World at War maps, being Shino, Numa, Varuk, Nocturne, Toten, and Darice, and I played all those maps, and really enjoyed it. And honestly, like, I'm putting up the footage here of my Shino, Numa round 1,000 gameplay, and like, you can get to round 10,000 on this map. The world record was actually recently just beaten, and I feel like this game, because of the glitches, actually adds so much more replayability, and so much more fun. Now, granted, obviously, a game like BO4 has way better mechanics in terms of just like all of the stuff that you can do, all the Easter eggs and stuff, but I mean, in terms of the replayability with Darice and playing it with friends and playing it with people that actually have this game and own this game, I think World at War is an absolute classic. You also have World at War zombies, custom zombies, and I think that alone is the reason why World at War is ahead of Black Ops 4. If it wasn't for the custom zombies, I definitely wouldn't have put it up here, because the custom zombies is so, so important to have on World at War. It basically cemented everything that was coming up for the future of zombies. It let people practice new ideas. It was an amazing game mode, and I still have so many hours on World at War because of custom zombies, and it is truly one of my favorite experiences in Call of Duty Zombies. Now, coming in to our next spot, I think you guys are really going to like this one, and honestly, I think this game mode actually got a little bit too much hate at the spawn of its life cycle, including myself giving it hate. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Infinite Warfare Zombies. Now, IW Zombies really suffers, in my opinion, from not necessarily having bad gameplay mechanics, because I think the gameplay mechanics are amazing. I love the double pack punch. I love the perk mechanics. I love the way that the guns are. I love the card system. It all melds perfectly. I think the thing that deteriorates this game mode really is the maps. Like, Spaceland is an all-time classic zombies map, but every other DLC after it really just did not shine as far as Spaceland did. Rave is a good map. Shaolin, I would even consider to be not bad. But then Attack of the Radioactive Thing and Beast are just such nightmares. They're such a mess just to deal with in all general. And that is why I have to say IW Zombies does, in my opinion, deserve to be above BO4, just because I believe that I've actually played it much more than I've gone for higher rounds. But it really pisses me off, because if this game had some BO3 level maps, oh my goodness, I would have loved it so, so much more. And obviously, I have to say that this list is obviously a subjective opinion based. If you have any objective things that you guys would like to say in the chat, in the comments, I would be happy to say. And I just love all the gun mechanics with this game. I love the way that the crates worked in this. I love the way that you could get better weapons just by playing more. There's a great ranking system. Like, this game, I always say, has some of the best gameplay mechanics in all of Call of Duty Zombies, in every single Zombies game. It's literally only the maps. And also, again, some of the enemies are not that great. Like, this whole Beast from Beyond map is easily one of the worst Zombies maps ever made. It's truly garbage. There's not a lot of fun that you can be had on this game, but you know what? Still love IW, and it still has brought in the best super Easter egg in all of Call of Duty Zombies. So in terms of gameplay mechanics, IW deserves to be an S tier, but in terms of everything else, I really do believe that the maps have dragged this game down. But I have to say that this is the best non-Treyarch game mode in all of Call of Duty Zombies. Without a doubt, this is the best. I don't think that anything non-Treyarch compares to IW Zombies as of right now, but this game is still the number one non-Treyarch Zombies game. Now, coming into our next spot, I think a lot of people are going to also be disappointed by this pick, because honestly, I am not as big of a fan as this game as a lot of people think I am. This was actually the game that I was actually about to quit Call of Duty Zombies in all general, but then I decided to make a YouTube channel with Mob the Dead. This is Black Ops 2. Now with this game, I actually have a Cold War mod on, but it's Black Ops 2 Die Rise gameplay. It's fully BO2. It's an amazing game. I love BO2 in terms of, again, it has the BO4 effect. It has some amazing perks, some amazing maps, but also some of the worst perks, and also some of the worst maps. So it's, again, you get the best of the best and the best of the worst, I guess. So I don't know. I like BO2, and going back to it and learning these maps much more now in terms of like actually understanding all the little gimmicks of them, it makes me feel better about this game. And I love going back to it, obviously, for playing Mob the Dead, for playing Origins. It has, again, some of the greatest maps. But the problem is, again, is this was not even a singular creator's creation, I guess you could say. It was between Jason Bundell and Jimmy Zielinski at the time, and Jimmy Zielinski made a lot of the maps that people didn't like, while Jason Bundell made the maps that everybody loved on this game, which is essentially what brought him into BO3. But the thing is, man, is, again, there's so much replayability with Black Ops 2 with co-op, which is why I love it. There's so much, like, the Super Easter Egg on BO2 is actually really fun. I think it's just so great to come back to and play this game. But, again, I feel like it also has the same thing with the IW effect. It suffers from the maps. It suffers from solo actually being detrimented a lot on these maps, because a lot of these maps, you just can't really do the Easter Egg solo. You have to either have four players to do a specific section of the Easter Egg. And I feel like it just takes out a lot of content of this game that was really made well in BO3. But in BO2, you could see how everything was just melding towards it. And again, I like BO2. It's easily one of my favorite zombies games. Like, literally, we're in the top four now. This is top five zombies games, with IW being number five. But still, I think BO2 also got a little bit unbalanced on some maps. Some of the Wonder Weapons were amazing. Some of them, like the Jet Gun, were terrible. So, again, it's 50-50. It's definitely not my favorite. So, coming in into our next spot, I think you guys are also, yet again, going to be shocked and surprise about this one. This is actually going to be, and I think, again, a lot of people are going to be shocked about this, because I think a lot of people were haters of this. It's Black Ops Cold War. Black Ops Cold War is a great game in terms of the meta. The gameplay mechanics kept me playing it because there's always something new to find. There's always a new best gun. The Wonder Weapons were fun. The gameplay mechanics were great. I love this game, like IW Zombies, where I think the game mechanics are basically neck and neck with each other. They're just so much fun to play. I think, again, the problem with Cold War is also just the maps, man. The maps are just nothing really new. They're nothing that fun. Like, I really do like Mauer. I really do like D-Machine. But in terms of, like, any new maps, I think this game could have actually been elevated so much more if a Zombies Chronicles 2 came to it, if we had Transit, Buried, and Die Rise coming to it. The Victus maps would have been amazing. I love the system of this game. I love the perks. I love everything about this game, except that it does lack personality, and that's where I think it just loses out on a lot of points. But I still believe that this is my... In terms of the story, I didn't really like it. I mean, I thought they could have done way better, but I mean, again, the operators are cool, but also just lack a lot of story, and I think Cold War definitely deserves to be up here in terms of the gameplay, but in terms of the story, it really doesn't offer anything too exciting, and I think that is the reason why I have to put it this low, even though it's literally number three up here. Again, I love Black Ops Cold War, but in my opinion, hasn't really captured the essence of what Zombies should have been, in my opinion. But now, coming in into our number two spot, again, I think this is also going to be controversial, because I think a lot of people do not understand this. This is going to be Black Ops 1. Now, with Black Ops 1, I have a custom Zombies map here of a DLC 5 called Parish, which actually was going to be what Moon was supposed to be. It was supposed to be a Paris map, and these people actually went back and made it, and I'm playing this map, and it's an amazing Black Ops 1 custom Zombies mod. I absolutely love it. There's a lot of Origins vibes to it, but into Black Ops 1, into the actuality of it, it's just made everything from World at War more refined. The Black Ops ones have got the maps. They have to be the most iconic. Everybody knows Keynoter Toten. Everybody knows Ascension. People have played Dereis because of Black Ops 1. And that's where I feel like Black Ops 1 definitely deserves to be the number two spot. It's just so iconic in everybody's mind. Nobody will ever forget Black Ops 1, even though it is over 10 years old at this point. It's such a standout game with just the personality mentality, the start of Easter eggs. There are so many great wonder weapons that are so unique and iconic that I think to this day, Black Ops 1 has never ever had a true competitor in terms of the way that the wonder weapons are on this map. They are so unique, filled with life, filled with love. This was when Treyarch was truly, in my opinion, at its prime, and I think it shows with just how beautiful this game even still looks as being a 2010 game all the way in 2022. I absolutely adore Black Ops 1. Now, again, a complaint about Black Ops 1 I could have is high rounds are exceedingly difficult. You know, it is difficult to get a lot of time in on this map. I definitely have played this game much more than I have even a lot of the other Black Ops games and obviously the non-Treyarch games. This game is phenomenal from back to front. It is such a cohesive story. It's not confusing. It's an amazing, amazing video game, and I still think that a lot of aspects of BO1 I don't think will ever be recreated. Just in terms of the fact that BO1, in terms of its overall game, multiplayer, zombies, and campaign, were such standouts. They were just so amazing, and I really do believe that Black Ops 1 Zombies still to this day is one of the greatest zombie experiences of all time. And again, not a lot of maps that I dislike in this, even disliking Shang for a while, I'd still go back and play Shang. It's just so unique. It's so much fun. And I think that is really the thing that we're missing in Zombies recently, is just the map atmosphere. We're tired of getting recycled maps. We're tired of getting maps that we've played 900,000 times in the past. We want something new. And that is where BO1 really delivered on every single DLC. Even the trailers were fun. Call of the Dead is one of my favorite maps of all time. Having a lot of these cool BO1 custom Zombies maps also enriches the experience and makes it so much more better. But that is why, personally, I believe BO1 is better than Cold War and also better than Black Ops 2. Now, coming in to our number one spot, I don't think anybody could have seen this coming, chat. I'm not even gonna lie, I don't think anyone could have seen this coming. Really, I genuinely don't think so. I really don't. But coming into our number spot, lads, you could have guessed it. We all could have guessed it. It's Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3 is still my favorite Zombies game. After all these years, after 5 years, after all the custom maps, after all the amazing innovations and features that mod developers are bringing to this game, and literally, it's coming to the point now where these people are trying to find new, or they're trying to develop a new game now because the BO3 system now is becoming too limited with the custom map capability. And don't even get me started on the main maps. All the main BO3 maps are iconic from head to toe, from Shadows of Evil all the way to Revelations. I definitely say BO3 was the peak of Zombies. It had the greatest cutscenes. It had the most iconic and fun weapons that people would love. I enjoyed the double pack a bunch system. I think this game was overpowered, but I think Call of Duty is at its best when it's overpowered. I think when you're trying to nerf the experience like BO4 or anything like that, that's when the experience really starts to dull. And it's like you're in an AI mode. It's a player versus AI game mode. You should allow the player to feel as strong as possible. That's the point of the wonder weapons. That's the point of gathering all the perks. That's the point of spawning in on the map and literally only having a pistol, because you want to progress from the beginning all the way to the end and make sure you capture every single detail that you need to within the Zombies experience. I absolutely love BO3 Zombies. I still play it almost every single day leading up to this video, and I probably will until maybe COD 2023 or COD 2024 comes out. And it's sad because it's like, I've even said this back in the day before BO4 came out, and when BO4 came out, everyone was just going back into those videos and just saying how sad it was because we had such high expectations. We really thought it could have been another BO3, but it's really just sad to say that, like, honestly, I really don't know if this game will ever be recreated to the glory that it was originally designed to be as. And just seeing all the custom map capability, it's infinite. The potential is limitless with Black Ops 3, and that is why it always, in my opinion, deserves to be number one, because this is the only game out of all 10 games that people are still creating content on. It doesn't even matter when it released back in 2015. As long as people are still making content on this game, that that is instantly, in my opinion, what puts it at the number one spot, because the mechanics and the gameplay are constantly being re-innovated, being re-challenged, being redeveloped by people, and seeing people upgrade and go through these gameplay mechanics and actually see the full potential of what Black Ops 3 Zombies can be is super exciting. And again, it really makes me hope that a BO3 Custom Zombies sometimes would just release into consoles so that we could get it out to more players, more people could create more of their maps, because like, just look at this gameplay. This is absolutely stunning, and I really do love Black Ops 3. And I mean, there's really nothing else more to say. There's no other game that's more replayable than this. And I think that until the time comes, maybe the only game that will ever be BL3 for me will be something that's made by Deviation Games, by Jason Bundell, by the original creator of this game. So that is why I have such faith in him. I really do believe that because of his talent, because of his works on this game, he can truly create a product that everyone's going to love to play once Deviation Games actually makes their video game. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming out. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see y'all in that next one, baby.